Assassin's Creed Syndicate. What we know is you can now hijack carriages, hence Grand Theft Carriage. You also have a grappling hook, which is awesome because now you'll be able to scale buildings faster than ever before. And also use some pretty brutal combat techniques. I'm pretty sure the throwing knife is now more useful for the assassin, and his name is Jacob. But for all you people out there that were complaining and making a big deal about it, well, you can now play as a woman assassin, and her name is Evie. No, not that Evie. No. This Evie is very stealthy. And so it's almost polar opposite of Jacob. But they are brother and sister. Twins, in fact. So this will play really awesome into the story of how they'll interact. Now, with two assassins, you would think, oh, this would be a great co-op game. Sorry, not going to happen. This game is single player only, which means no competitive multiplayer, no co-op multiplayer that you maybe enjoyed from Unity. I don't know. But single player only on next gen or current gen consoles, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. No love for you guys on the 360 or PS3. It's time to update. Ubisoft will no longer be creating games for that past generation, so just another reason to update, my friends. Look at those sexy systems. Buy it. Do it. Do it. Do it! Now, moving on. We know there are going to be many editions of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, starting off with your standard edition, which will include the two secondary single-player missions, Darwin and Dickens conspiracy missions. It should provide you with an extra hour of gameplay. Now, the Gold Edition includes the season pass and the two extra missions, but an exclusive Baker Street outfit. Woohoo! Next thing is the Assassin's Creed Syndicate Rooks Edition. Now, this is going to be like the next step up from the standard edition. This will come with the game, of course, exclusive collector's box, a double-sided London map, high-quality art book, and the official soundtrack. Then we have the Assassin's Creed Syndicate Charing Cross Edition. This will be another next step up for all you collectors out there. Look at that epic figurine of Jacob standing on the crossroad in the shape of Assassin's Creed logo. It looks sweet. Probably going to get this edition, not going to lie. Add it to my statue collection. This will, of course, come with that statue I was talking about there. The Jacob standing on the crossroad. An exclusive collector's box that will allow you to display your figure on it. A double-sided London map, high-quality art book, and the official soundtrack, just like the other ones. Of course, it will come with the two extra missions, Darwin's and Dickens' Conspiracy, and the Runaway Train mission. Now it's time to talk about the big one, the Big Ben Collector's Case. This is the primo collector's edition for all you collectors out there, man. Look at that statue. It's the first thing that pops out at you. The statue looks awesome. Same pose as it was in the Charing Cross edition, but this time with an epic background of Big Ben machinery going on. This also comes with the double-sided London map, the game soundtrack, and of course the two bonus missions. But what separates this one? Oh yeah, we got the exclusive future pack, which looks like a steelbook edition of the steelbook. It comes with a numbered lithography chosen by the fans who pre-order. That's pretty cool. I like those things. Very high quality art there. Also, it comes with a Big Ben's collector box. This is a box, I'm telling you. Now, it comes with a premium hip flask for all you alcoholics out there. Or people just like to drink. Maybe if for Tyrion. Tyrion would love this. It comes with a premium hip flask with the Assassin's Creed Syndicate logo on the side of it. Very nice. Also, the season pass is included in this edition. So therefore, you may end up balancing out, depending on how much the season pass will be offering. If it's $60 or $50, you might as well go with this edition. And if you go to Amazon.com, you can check out their Assassin's Creed Syndicate listings. Yes, it's already up for pre-order on Amazon.com. But things that were not mentioned. We have Assassin's Creed Syndicate, the Assassin's Gauntlet with Hidden Blade. This is a life-size Hidden Blade. The other one is a Syndicate Cane Sword. Life-size Cane Sword. Yes, it's spring-loaded, button-triggered, and yeah, it's awesome. It looks cool. You can look them up right there. Look at the descriptions. And so yeah, there's for all the editions of the game. Lots of editions of the game. It's time to move on to E3 2015 predictions. When it comes to Assassin's Creed Syndicate, what will we see from Ubisoft? Well, we're talking two different assassins. And I think we will see the juxtaposition. God, that's a big word, and I just used it. Between the two assassins and how the gameplay will change drastically depending on which assassin you are. So I'm throwing this out there right now. I think you will be able to swap between the two assassins in mid-gameplay just as you could in Grand Theft Auto if you're familiar with that. I think you'll be able to, with a touch of a button, you'll switch to a different assassin and you'll be able to set up different things. I think that would be amazing and that would be a really cool gameplay addition. And I think we'll probably see a demo or something displaying how that works at E3. That's just me. It was rumored at one point that you'd be able to swap between the two characters. And also with all this the stuff going on with Unity, how there wasn't a woman assassin and there was a big deal about it. Well, you get to play as Evie this time. And you'll get to play as Jacob at the same time. And they, as I mentioned previously, Evie will be more stealthy. Jacob is more of a brawler. So swapping between those two characters could set up a really cool dynamic of gameplay. Also, when it comes to E3, I think we're going to see a little more of things that happen outside the Animus. This was a big issue for me with Unity, where we barely ever went outside the Animus. And I think we're going to start exploring that a little more at E3 to give fans a little hope for a more in-depth story. Now, we know so much about this game because it was basically just unloaded this week, and there was really leaves you no room for speculation, but that's what I'm predicting. I think we're going to see character swap gameplay, and it's going to set up some really nice strategy. We know there's no multiplayer, so we can't see anything on that. I mean, this E3, if you're going to do any kind of Assassin's Creed news, it's going to have to be something big. It's got to be a bombshell, and I'm telling you, man, outside the Animus storyline, swapping characters. That's my E3 predictions. I'll see you next time on the countdown to E3. Game over.